Morning reveals a cloudless sky as the crew awakes to snowy peaks on the horizon and the hum of rotor blades. It is an awe-inspiring setting in which a Warren Miller crew feels right at home. Our dream of heli skiing the Himalayas is finally becoming a reality. The helicopter, a French-built Lama, has been dismantled in Switzerland and shipped to India on a 747. We hope that it was reassembled properly as the pilot flies us into the thin mountain air over the vast expanses of the Himalaya. The metallic click of boot into binding is never so loud as when it echoes over a wilderness that knows only the voice of the wind. Reassured by many seasons of experience and intent on descending these unskied faces, we drop in.
Flying up in the, you know, the 20,000 foot areas and skiing at, I guess, 18, 19,000 feet. And one of the fears I had was the pulmonary edema. You know, we didn't really know how we were going to react to the altitude since we didn't climatize at all.
A quick ascent without acclimatization can cause accumulation of fluid in the lungs, making breathing a difficult task. Pulmonary edema is dangerous and can even be fatal to the unwary. A safe window of opportunity was a mere 90 minutes before we had to descend to a safer elevation.
We had never gone anywhere near that altitude in a helicopter before. And as you know, the air gets thinner and it makes it more difficult to take a helicopter to that altitude. And one of my fears was maybe the air would have just been too thin and the helicopter would have dropped.
Clawing its way to 18,500 feet, the Lama lands atop a peak floating like an island in a sea of snow and ice. We ascend to a high-altitude world, hemmed in by towering peaks, split by canyons and valleys, hiding legendary lost kingdoms.
A different texture of snow than anything that I had ever skied before. Every time we get a face shot, it was like getting sandblasted.
The scenery, the mountains, the helicopter, getting into it, flying up, it just absolutely left us breathless.
Our North American counterparts are packing their skis away for the summer while we ski endless powder in the Himalaya of India.
The first realization that I had of the altitude was when I bent down to buckle up my boots and stood back up again. I swear, I almost fell down. Typically, we could only go about maybe 30 or 40 turns at that altitude before our thighs were burning and our lungs were ready to collapse.
Scenery in the Himalayas are much more extreme, and the faces were steeper than we normally skied. Of course, the altitude made you work for it a lot harder, and it's an unforgettable experience.
To actually be helicopter skiing in the Himalayas was a dream come true. The mountains were bigger and more pristine than I had ever imagined. The quality of the snow was unique to anything I'd ever skied before. It was really one of my life's great experiences.